Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do an empties video for August, and I'm really excited because there's a lot in the basket this month. Some of them are just packaging I want to get rid of and talk a little bit about, and some of them are declutters, and some of them are used up. I have some tallies down in the description box where you can see how much I used up, the value of the products from each month this year and for each video, and I will have them linked down below as well. Let me show you the three items that I have that are declutters for this month. Two of them are sunscreens because they just don't work anymore because I bought them last year, and sunscreen only lasts a year. Because I live in Denmark, the sun is only out in the spring and summertime. I'm not going to use SPF in the fall and winter time because the sun is just not strong enough for me to get a sunburn. Some of you would probably think it's not healthy, but I promise you guys, the sun is not strong enough to cause any damage on my body or on my face. In my face cream, I will from now on maybe see if I can find something with SPF, but for my body, it's fine, I don't get a sunburn. And in the fall and winter time, it's so cold in Denmark that you are covered up anyway. Take it as you want to. This is from Lidl, I believe. It is the CN Sun Lotion with SPF 30. And this is the Nivea Sun Protect and Moisture with SPF 15. Yeah, it is a medium, but it's only 15. So I use this on the lighter days and then on the more sunny days. This one is probably down to here, and this one is here or something. So, money wasted here, basically. But yeah, I don't want to buy anything expensive because, in my opinion, it's a waste of money because we don't use it that much because the sun is just not out enough. The other one is a mask, and this is My Moments by Matas, and that is a Danish chain. Like Ulta or something. This is a boosting vitamin gel mask. I really, really like this. It has some B3, A vitamin, E vitamin, C, green tea. It has some really nice ingredients, and it did work a lot. My skin was really moisturized after this. I'm not going to buy this again because I really like the sleeping mask that I have, and it works so well for me. Like insanely well. So I really like that moisturizing mask over this because you were going to have this sit on your skin for like 10 or 15 minutes and rinse it off. I really like the overnight thing because then I don't have to do anything. Lazy person mind, but yeah, it was a great mask. I didn't pay anything for it because I got it in an advent calendar. So yeah, I have had this open for almost 2 years now, so it does not work anymore, and I do break out from it. This is just the container. It is the Matas Natura body lotion with some berries and organic aloe vera, no parabens, no color things, and no perfume. It's a really, really nice brand, this Matas Natura line. Wow, I'm talking Danish because it's in Danish. I'm sorry. This is a really, really nice body lotion. I have decanted into a tub from the body shop that I finished earlier this year, I believe. So I finished that body lotion, then I decant this into that because it has this kind of nozzle that pops up. I hate this. I hate the packaging so much. So yeah, this is just decant, and it is completely empty because I have had it upside down for like months. There is nothing in it, so it's in that container now. This is really light and moisturizing, so this is really, really nice if you can get a hold of it. If you're in Denmark, well, you can. It's my choice. So this is really, really nice, and it smells really good. The W7 Lifesa Beach Body Contour Sculpting Body Cream. This is a glittery, shimmering lotion. Doesn't moisturize, but it's a beautiful lotion that I just didn't get the use out of. It took me half a year or something to get that progress, so I just dumped it into a body lotion. I have this in my Harry Potter project pan, so I do count this as an empty because I dumped it in a body lotion that I have in that project as well. It is the Yves Rocher Raspberry and Peppermint body lotion, and I'm really going to try to finish that off before fall gets here for real. So this is an empty packaging, and when I finish the lotion, I also finish this, but I just count it as an empty because there's nothing in here, you know? There's nothing in there. I'm not going to buy anything like this again. I have two darker shades in my collection. This was the lightest. So maybe I should just have used the darkest, but I didn't think. I don't know why, but yeah. I don't have a need for these in my collection. It's beautiful, but I can use a highlighter for that. And if I want a shimmering body lotion, I can just crush up some highlighter and put that in. It's fine. I'm good. I'm not done. This is a packaging empty as well. This is the Matas Pomegranate Hand Cream. This is a smaller deluxe size with 15 milliliters in it. Felix got a hold of it. There. His tooth. He thought it was a good idea to bite this. So there's a hole. Can't do anything about that. So I also decant this little tube into a small body shop container that I have in my 19 and 19. If you follow that product, you know. And I just put it in there because it was with another hand cream. It's fine. So yeah, I'm going to use it up that way because it's not going to this because it leaks everywhere because there's holes in it now. My life with a cat now. I'm still getting used to it even though it has been like 1.5 months since we got him. Yeah, let's just take the big one out of the way. This is a Sanex Dermo Natural Wheat Germ Oil and Vitamin E Dry Skin Shower Gel. This is a big one. You see, it's bigger than my head. 1000 milliliters, so it's like 1 liter. We have 4 left of these. We buy them at the border shop, where it was really cheap, and we bought it way before I wanted to buy cruelty-free stuff, so this sucks a little bit. But we're using them up and they're really, really nice. If you don't care about cruelty-free stuff, these are really, really nice. And if you live by the borderline in Flecko, this is amazing. This is really, really nice, the wheat one. We have the natural, the just plain one. It's not as good as the wheat one because there's some oils in this one. My boyfriend used this as well, so he helps me like that one, but we'll never buy that again because it's not cruelty-free. And this is the Yves Rocher Raspberry Peppermint Shower Gel. This was a red shower gel. Doesn't really matter, but I thought it was fun to mention it was red once. This is the twin for the body lotion that I talked about, where I put the shimmer body lotion in. This smelled really, really nice. It grew on me, for sure, it did. I don't know if I'm going to buy fancy shower gel, maybe once in a while, but not on a regular basis anymore. They don't do so much for me that I think it is a necessity for my bath time shower routine to have a nice smelling shower gel. I don't know. I just like these types of things. I'm boring that way. Okay, I just put this into my Mission 100% Cruelty Free project pan. But if you saw the project, you know I was going to finish really soon because I had 1 or 2 uses left. I was up to here when I put it in. So it was going to be done for sure. This is the Schwarzkopf Gliss Hair Repair 1 minute intensive mask. It was really, really nice, but Schwarzkopf is not cruelty free, so I can't buy this again. And I have a new hair mask going that is cruelty free, so that is really nice. Schwarzkopf is an amazing brand, and I hate that they are not cruelty free. I really hate that because they make amazing hair dye, amazing hair stuff. They are really, really great. I'm so sad. And this was really, really nice for my hair. My hair loved that hair mask. I have a body lotion from Matas again. It is the same line as the small hand cream, the pomegranate line. It's really, really nice. This body lotion is amazing, and pomegranate is one of my favorite scents. Smells amazing. Oh my god, I miss this body lotion so much. Yeah, I'm going to buy this again when I run out of lotion. I have no idea when that is, but I'm going to buy this again because this is affordable. It smells amazing and my skin loves it. It's not thick or thin, it's just the perfect in between. I love it. I have some Zendium toothpaste. If you're Danish, do you know if Zendium is cruelty-free? Let me know. I have a lot of tubes left in my stash, but do you know if it is cruelty-free or not? I don't know anything about toothpaste and I can't find anything about this. If it's not, do you know any affordable toothpaste that I can get a hold of in Denmark? Let me know. I have some skincare empties. One is a face serum. It is the moisturizing face serum Nordic for all skin types from Ravnsborg. This is a Danish brand. This was an amazing serum. I don't want to say it is expensive, but it's a little bit out of my price range when I don't have the biggest income. It's a really, really nice serum and I will buy it again when I get a higher salary each month. So yeah. It's really, really nice and comes with a pump, which is amazing. And it is an airless pump, so it goes up. I love this. I really do. And I miss it. But I need to find a cheaper alternative until I get a nice, decent job. You know? The last skincare item, or something that is not makeup, it is the Matas Natur eye cream with E vitamin and aloe vera. It is the same line as the body lotion that I talked to you guys before. This is just the skincare line in this range, you know. And so that is why it's white. I have a new one going already. This is amazing. And oh yeah, and it comes with a pump. Amazing. And it is an airless pump, so you are sure you get the last little bit out of this product, which is always amazing in my eyes. Eye cream, wow. It's amazing eye cream and it is organic and everything, so it's a nice product. And yes, it is cruelty free because it's Danish. I like Danish brands and I like that it is safe for my cruelty free status. So I'm sorry for you guys that can't get it. I have two nail things that are empty. One of them is my Essence Active Protection Anti-Split Nail Sealer Anti-Break Base Coat. I was going to find this again in the Essence booth in Bilka. If you're Danish, you know. It's like a big supermarket, you know, hardware store. I couldn't find this anymore. Is this not a thing anymore? It is amazing though. My nails love this and they don't split as quickly as they should or they would if I didn't use this, you know. So this is amazing for my nails, but I can't find anything like it. I find something similar, but not this. I really want this again. There's the tiniest bit left in the bottle, but that is so thick that it's not going to happen. I can't get that off or out. I can't. And then I have a nail polish empty. I haven't showed you guys this in my putty polish yet, but if you saw my update, you knew I was down to here, so it was almost done. This is the Catrice Cosmetics Luxury Nudes Satin Shine Delight in Pure Light nail polish. I had an accident. So yeah, this is a nude color with a sheen to it. So it has micro glitters in it and it has like a pink shift to it. It's really, really beautiful. And it is the perfect nude for me. And yeah, I can buy this again if I can find it, but you can't get Catrice in Denmark, so that is really a bummer. But if I can find it, I might pick it up again. I do have one or two nudes in my collection or nail polish dust that I really want to finish before, but it's a really, really nice one because it lasts on my nails and it is opaque in the first coat and it's just really, really nice. And my nails are rubbish, so that says a lot if I like a nail polish. The last three items are makeup and I have a Noble Nordic mascara. This is the second mascara I think I have finished of this. And it is the Hey Friends mascara. It is lengthening, it is defining, it is waterproof. It is everything that I want in a mascara. It is just too goopy now. I have had it open for like 4 months. So this is the brush. It has a curve, but it is a flat brush. It has a lot of product here on the side and that is just what you put on and then you use the bristles to comb it out. I have ordered two more online because there was a sale. And I have a new one going now. So I kind of have three, now. I love this mascara. I will forever buy that mascara. It is so nice. It's not the cheapest mascara, but it works for me, and that is everything to me. I have the Maybelline Instant Anti-Age the Eraser Eye Concealer. It is in the shade Light. When I got this, it was the lightest shade in the range, but since then, there has come some lighter shades in the range, and I'm really bummed out that Maybelline isn't cruelty-free, because I can't buy that, because I'm trying to just buy cruelty-free stuff, as you may know. I can't try the lightest shade in this range, and that bums me out, because this is amazing concealer. It covers everything, and I actually don't mind the sponge thingy, and it is, when you twist here, the product goes down, so you know you get everything. So it's not, there's nothing stuck in the side, to the sides or anything. It's just amazing, and it lasts amazingly long. It's just really, really nice, and I'm so sad that I can't buy this anymore. Until Maybelline goes cruelty-free, of course. Then I have the MiMiMi Lip Glide Crayon in Playful Peach. As you can see, it is so tiny, and there's nothing in here anymore. I poked everything out just to see how much there was in, and there was a ton of it. But I couldn't sharpen it anymore, so I just called it done. It is done. I don't want to use the one I poked out. I'm not up for that. I have so much lipstick. I'm really excited to finish the lipstick, but this certain lipstick is not really great. I got it in a glossy box. Glossy box or goodie box? I can't remember. A subscription box, you know. So I didn't buy this myself. I didn't choose it, but I just got it. That's the thing I don't like about subscription boxes. You don't know what you get. At least with beauty, where I'm extremely picky. I don't know. It's a rather thick formula of a crayon. It is a lipstick formula, you know. But it makes a line inside your mouth. You know when you get lipstick on your teeth, and that is because you put your lipstick in too far into your mouth, you know? You can't do that with this, which is a good thing. You can't get product on your teeth, but that means you get a crisp line in the inner rim of your lips, and that is not a good look, because then it's like balling up, if you can say it like that. So I really like it with this lip gloss that I have on today, that I have in my graveyard project pan, but I don't have this anymore, so because I'm just tossing the bit I put out. I'm not going to fuss with that, but I was just really curious to see how much that was in. This is a done product, and I'm really excited to call another lipstick done in my collection. I have so many, and I'm so excited to have one less. So we ended on a high note for this video, and I'm really excited about that. Sometimes we end on a bad note, but I think that is because we didn't talk about the makeup in the beginning. So if you wanted that in the future, please let me know. I prefer that, but I also want to please you guys. I was going to say small empties, but it's not this time. It's really big, and I have a lot to talk about, so it's probably half hour long. I'm really sorry. I'm going to get some coffee and some water or something, because my throat is dry. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I have a whole playlist with my empties, so if you love these kind of videos, please subscribe down below, because I do them every month. Even though I don't have that many empties that month, I do them anyway. I think it is interesting. And then you can get a short video and a little bit more in-depth reviews. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and until the next video, please take care.